I am humbled, thankful, and still uncertain how it all came together, but I believe everybody has a story. I can say this is one of those times where I can give. This is not my day. This is Mrs. Fanny Three's day. This is Coach Thompson's day. This is my entire family and friends who has contributed to this particular moment. This is everyone whose selflessness I spend every day trying to repay. I want to thank you all for recognizing me and all of them. Thank you so much for this amazing honor, and God bless you all.
Oh, it was a memorable few days in Springfield, Massachusetts this past August. We had the privilege of being there to see Alonzo Mourning enshrined to the Basketball Hall of Fame with the class of 2014. Coach, the ultimate honor for the ultimate warrior and a guy that really typifies what a Heat lifer is all about.
You're right, Eric. Alonzo Mourning epitomizes the qualities of the Miami Heat organization. The hard work, the commitment, the resolve, and the championship basketball all rolled into one. It's outstanding.
Well, truly an honor well-deserved for Alonzo Mourning. And as Zoe was finishing his on-court career with the Heat, the mantles of leadership and loyalty that he so honorably embraced are being handed down to a couple of younger teammates. And their careers overlap briefly, highlighted by that unforgettable championship season of 2006, when all three played a pivotal role in securing the Heat's first NBA title. Dwayne Wade and Udonis Haslem joined this franchise together as rookies back in 2003. The 2014-15 campaign will mark their 12th season as Heat teammates. And since day one of year one, they have been all about the Heat and all about heart.
Congratulations. I see you. We are happy. Very, very happy.
Words can't describe it. How much it means to me to look and see that, you know, when I came in as a skinny kid a couple years ago, and now to look and see that I'm looking towards the future and I can see that, you know, me one day, you know, retiring, you know, here in Miami, you know, in the same uniform I wore since day one, it's special.
Wade, puts it up. It's
yes!
Good!
Stan Van Gundy went to the rookie and he delivered.
It's always in the back of my mind how I had to get here, what I had to do to get here, where I came from to get here, not being drafted, you know, doing the 8-month bid overseas, coming here, try out, and there's 30 other guys here, and it's like, wow, it's like 30 guys here. Am I gonna be the one to make it out of the 30? You know, it's not a day goes by, but I don't realize, you know, where I came from, what I had to go through to get to where I am now.
Miami has won! Miami is NBA champs! Kings of the Hill!
It's like a 1,000-pound weight off my shoulder, man, because nobody never gave me a chance. Nobody never gave me nothing. But I just continued to work hard. I'm just thankful.
Woo! We're on top of the world!
I can hang my head on being a guy that, you know, possibly can go down playing with one organization. I'll always be a Heat, you know, from forever. I'm a lifer. That's how I look at it, and that's how I know that the organization looks at it as well. So, you know, it's a good position to be in.
It's very important. It's really all I know. From day one when I stepped in the league, and even before I played in the NBA, just watching the Miami Heat, the Grant Longs, the Alonzo Mournings, and going back to the Steve Smiths and those guys like that, it's really all I know. And it was a dream come true to have an opportunity to play here and continue to play here in front of my family, my friends, and win a championship here. You know, if I had to plan it out, I couldn't have planned it any better. So, you know, for me, it's on a whole nother level just to put on this jersey and go out and play every night.
I feel like I'm in the best position possible, you know, that you can be in. You know, not only am I a part of a great organization, and to have the opportunity to play once again with Udonis Haslem, you know, a guy who I look at as a brother of mine. I just could not see myself being here, you know, without him. Even though, you know, over the course of the years, you lose a lot of teammates, you lose a lot of good friends, but, you know, I just felt that it just wouldn't have been right, it wouldn't have been complete if he wasn't here.
I don't even consider Dwayne a friend anymore. He's like family now, you know. My family is, you know, close with his family. You know, my son plays with his son.
It's someone that I'm just so comfortable and confident with, and someone I can go to about anything. You know, just makes your life a lot easier to have someone like that behind you.
We've been here the longest. We know what it's about. We played for Coach Riley. We played for Coach Van Gundy, and now for Coach Spoelstra, man. And we understand the system more so than anybody.
Here in Miami, it's first class. And you're going to see, you know, that from Coach Riley. You've seen that from Mickey. And we're going to see it from Coach Spo. And, you know, us as captains has got to just make sure that everyone else on the team in an organization follows that same path.
In my mind, you know, I'm a Heat for life. You know, this is my family. This is the only organization I know. They've given me an opportunity when nobody did early in my career, and I'll always be thankful and grateful to them for that. So I continue to try to bring them championships and be a part of as many as I can.
I'm proud, you know, and I'm happy, and I'm very grateful to still be, you know, wearing this Miami Heat uniform.
All of Heat Nation proud and happy that Dwayne Wade and Udonis Haslem will be continuing their careers as Miami Heat players. You talk about Heat lifers and the definition of Heat warriors. These two guys are that. And Coach, they also happen to have one other thing in common, three championship rings apiece.
Well, we know about their intangibles, Eric, their loyalty, their commitment to the team. It's great to just see these two guys lead this team to three championships, help lead them that way. And we know that they're going to have to do a lot this year to help the Heat stay in a competitive mode.
Yeah, I think a lot of people, especially outside of this marketplace, forgot what a good year Dwayne had a season ago. Shot a career high from the field, averaged 19 points per game. Yet with LeBron gone, more onus on Bosh and Dwayne, and we get the feeling that Dwayne's going to come back in great shape. What kind of year do you see ahead for Dwayne?
As a Heat fan, you love it when Dwayne Wade is doubted, because we know he always comes back better. He's lost some weight this summer. He's going to come back lighter. There's going to be more responsibility on his shoulders, and he's welcoming that. And he's going to go try to go back to his Hall of Fame playing career.
All right, Coach. Well, one of the true hallmarks of great leadership is the ability to provide a sense of calm and clarity when the noise outside is clamoring in chaos. The Heat acted swiftly and decisively to place themselves back into contention in the days following the departure of LeBron James. Shortly after the plan was in place, owner Mickey Arison addressed Heat Nation with a meaningful and motivational message.
While what your Miami Heat has accomplished in the last 4 years has been historic, there's a bigger picture that more clearly defines the success of what we've enjoyed as a franchise.
Since I took control of the team in 1995 and brought Pat Riley in to run basketball operations, the Heat has made the playoffs in 16 of those 19 full seasons.
With 5 Eastern Conference titles and 3 NBA championships highlighting those playoff appearances.
And while those accomplishments speak for themselves, I'm here to tell you something else. We are not done, not even close.
Pat Riley is fond of saying that the only thing you can count on in life is change, and those that embrace change are best prepared to emerge successfully.
So while the names on the back of the jerseys may change from time to time, the constant presence of the name Miami or Heat on the front guarantees our goal remains the same.
To put a competitive team on the floor capable of competing for the ultimate prize.
Like Dwayne said when he announced his return to the Heat, I'm a Heat lifer. That's how I want you to feel about your role as a Miami Heat fan, that you are a Heat lifer. All in, with us, for what is sure to be an exciting 2014-15 season.
And an incredibly bright future where we will look to add to our 3 NBA championships.
Sincerely, Mickey Arison, Heat lifer.
The response to this message was immediate and overwhelming. Equally appreciative of his commitment and composure, Heat Nation let their owner know that they were also in it for the long haul as a legion of Heat lifers sent in their remarks. Having successfully reached and reassured the fan base, I asked Mickey to reflect recently on his decision to write the letter.
I wanted to deal with all the noise that was going on this summer and try to put it into some kind of perspective. And obviously, since I've owned the team, we've had a great deal of success. We've had ups and downs, but we've won 3 championships. And we've focused on winning and winning big. And that's not going to change. That's our focus. That will continue to be our focus. And we hope they'll enjoy going on the ride with us.
As we head into season number 27 of Miami Heat basketball, how do you look back at the last 4 years, four straight trips to the finals, which was historic, and the back-to-back championships.
It was an amazing run, but, you know, who knows? It may not be over yet. We still have a lot of the key guys, so it wouldn't be bad to do it five times in a row.
Talk about the special bond you have over the last decade built with both Dwayne Wade and Udonis Haslem.
It's been amazing to watch them grow. They've been here for their entire careers. Clearly, they've been loyal Heat lifers. They are committed warriors, and we look forward to seeing them here for their entire careers.
Mickey, how important was it to you that Chris Bosh decided to remain with the Heat, and you guys offered him the maximum deal, and now he's here to stay?
I think it was critical. We clearly didn't want to take a huge step back. We wanted to be competitive, to be in a position to challenge in the East. And with Chris here and Dwayne here and the pieces we've added, we think we can compete.
Talk about moving forward into this next era of Heat basketball, you and Pat continuing to try to put the best and a championship product on the floor for Heat Nation.
Pat loves to think big, you know, and loves to think about the kind of talent you need to win championships, and he's always focused on that and driven by that.
Another longtime Heat lifer is Eric Spoelstra. It's been really interesting and remarkable to watch his career ascend.
Yeah, he's done a tremendous job. I think very often he doesn't get the credit he deserves, but over these number of years that he's been a head coach, he's always been competitive.
What does Heat lifer mean to you?
A Heat lifer is someone who'll stick through those ups and downs and continue to support the team. We got lots of them. When the slogan came out, when the letter hit our season ticket holders and the fans, the outpouring of support with hashtag Heat Lifer that I got both on Twitter and Instagram and everywhere was just amazing. So I thank everybody out there and look forward to another great season.
And we are too. You know, the Miami Heat began in 1988. The late Ted Arison, the original patriarch of this organization, and the Arison family, Tony, they have raised the bar and set the tone for a first-class, family-run, championship-contending organization.
Eric, the Arisons have always gone above and beyond the norm, starting with Ted Arison in 1988. Without him, there would have been no Heat franchise. And then all along the years, getting the free agents, spending the money that they had to, acquiring Pat Riley, and look at the three championships, being in the finals all those, you know, many times over the years. You just got to love what they do. They love basketball. And to tell you the truth, I think, in my opinion, the best professional relationship in sports is the Arisons and the Rileys, and we're very excited about the upcoming season.
And thanks to those two gentlemen, the Heat, an elite franchise. Well, the commitment is clear, the leadership locked in place. Now it's time to get to know some of the new faces who will help shape this season. Up next, you will meet the Heat.